You're looking at a medical miracle. A healthy eyeball in a dry socket whose tear glands no longer produce any moisture. After years of cancer treatment, I have severe dry eye syndrome. My eyes don't make any tears. Before I started using my own blood serum for eye drops, my eye surfaces were like parched moonscapes. Shortly after I started using the drops 5 years ago, a clear, smooth layer of new cells grew over my corneas and filled in the damage. This is not a cure for dry eye. It does not restore tear gland function. I still use commercial drops about every 40 minutes. But all I need is one drop of serum in each eye every morning to keep my eyes healthy. These living drops of my own blood, with the red cells removed, literally gave me my life back. It's been about 5 months since I made my last batch of drops, so today I'm distilling a new batch at home in 3 simple steps.
First one.
I have a friend here who is a nurse taking my blood. She's using a 23 gauge butterfly needle, but a larger needle would work a little bit better. I have used larger needles. I'd like to get 16 tubes, which means I'll end up with 32 bottles of eye drops. That should last me about 4 months. I bought the needles with a prescription from my doctor. I also bought a case of SSTs, these serum separation tubes, online from the same medical supply house. 16 tubes is convenient because the centrifuge I bought online for $190 has 8 slots. So I can do 2 flights of 8 tubes, spinning 3,300 RPM for 30 minutes. I let the blood rest for about 30 minutes before I start the centrifugal separation. You get more serum that way. We finished the blood draw about half an hour ago, so let's go ahead and load the centrifuge and get her spinning. Tubes. Lock her down. Set it on 30 minutes. Turn it on. The effectiveness of blood serum eye drops has been demonstrated in dozens of published research studies starting in 1984. Almost all of them dilute the patient's serum with saline or some other fluid, and I've tried that. But my eyes responded best to 100% serum. Mixing it with anything causes the growth factors, vitamins, and minerals to deteriorate more quickly. You have to remember that your blood serum is alive, and this limits the amount you can put in each individual dropper bottle. Okay, it's been about 30 minutes in the centrifuge, and we're ready to do the pour. As you can see, the red cells have gone to the bottom of each tube, and the amber serum has risen to the top. And there's about a teaspoon of serum there. And what I'm going to do is pour half of that into a bottle and the other half into a separate bottle. I have 32 empty eyedropper bottles here, all cleaned and dry. These are glass simulacin bottles, but I've also used plastic bottles. I just prefer glass in the freezer. Based on all the studies I've read and my own experience over the last 5 years, it's best to put only enough serum in each bottle for 3 or 4 days. Anything longer than that goes bad before you can use it. Remember, it's live serum and it spoils. Now I only use drops once a day, so I don't have to put very much serum in each bottle. It turns out it's going to be about a half teaspoon of serum per bottle, as you'll see in a minute. Each blood tube gives me 2 bottles of eye drops. And here's how I do it. Let's pop off the rubber stopper. Pour a bit in there. The rest in the second one. Now I'm going to discard all of the tubes legally. Let me put the tops on the eyedropper bottles. And this is the best part. It's the only time I can use these drops at body temperature, because the rest of the time it's going to be in the refrigerator. Miraculous. Okay, I have the first two bottles of autologous serum eye drops here that I just made. I'm going to put them where they go, which is right in the freezer. From my arm to the freezer in about an hour or less. And that's where they stay until I thaw them to use them, and I keep every bottle in the refrigerator while I'm using it.